The conservative leader, Aaron O'Toole, now on notice after his failure to break through in the federal election. This week, his own party voted to give themselves the power to potentially oust him if they choose, something they didn't do for Andrew Scheer after he lost the 2019 election. But Mr. O'Toole insists his caucus is fully united.
This is not about a sword of Damocles hanging over my head. We're united as a team. This is about having a fair and transparent process that a team must have when it respects one another.
During the election, Mr. O'Toole took a gamble by shifting toward the political center, not running as the true blue conservative he ran to win the leadership. But it didn't work. Now there are some open calls within his own party for a total rethink. So is his leadership really at risk? And what about the mandatory vaccine issue for members of parliament? Will conservatives support that? Let's find out. Joining me now is Conservative MP Michael Chong. Happy Thanksgiving to you, sir. Good to have you back on the program. So this week, the Conservative caucus voted to give itself the power to review Mr. O'Toole's leadership. Didn't do that for Andrew Scheer after 19. Is Aaron O'Toole's leadership on notice?
No, quite simply no. In fact, Aaron O'Toole voted for the rule that we enacted, the review and removal of the party leader rule, as did I. I voted for it each of the three last parliaments, including the current one, and so has Aaron O'Toole. So the fact that this rule passed, I think, is more of a mark of his confidence in his leadership.
The Conservatives won 69% of the vote in Alberta in 2019. The percentage dropped to 55% now. They lost three seats. They've got the gain of the PPC. The Ontario vote was down by 40,000. The 905, he's an MP in 905. The 905 riding votes were down 24,000 and two seats net. Like, did the Aaron O'Toole gamble pay off? And if not, what happened?
Well, I don't want to say in finality what went wrong and what went right, because that's what the review is all about. But I think there are obviously some things that went wrong during the campaign. We walked into a number of traps that the Liberals had set for us. I think about the trap for, concerning military style assault rifles that
why was that a Liberal trap? That was your platform that he reversed. Like, what was the trap?
Well, we didn't think through the way we included that in the platform.
Oh.
And then think through and didn't anticipate that the Liberals would turn this into attack. Same thing can be said about vaccines. The Prime Minister has been Prime Minister for the last year and a half of this pandemic, and right at the beginning of the campaign announced announced that vaccination policy, vaccine mandates. And so, those are issues that we didn't think through, didn't anticipate would become an issue when we wrote the platform.
But let me just press you on that, Mr. Chong. I mean, you call those Liberal traps, but I mean, vaccines are hardly a trap. You either have a position on it or not, and it actually continues to be a position. So the Liberals, the NDP, and the Bloc said, mandatory vaccines for all the candidates. Your party didn't do that. Now there's going to be vaccine mandates for planes and trains. No testing. Does your party support those?
Well, there was no discussion about vaccine mandates in the spring from the government. The government didn't indicate that it was coming forward with it. It simply decided at the beginning of an election campaign that it was going to make it a campaign issue. That's what I meant when I said that there had been no discussion about vaccination policy. I meant there'd been no discussion about vaccine mandates from this government until the campaign began. Regarding the government's announcement this week, it's a sweeping announcement. It encompasses not just the federal public service, but the federally regulated workplaces, federally regulated sectors. It encompasses travelers, both domestic and international. And so we're still studying the details of that proposal.
Vaccine mandates have been now discussed. We're 19 months into it. The government now, the Liberals have said, we support vaccine mandates. Unions support it. Businesses support it. Provinces support it. And you're saying that the Conservative Party is still studying it? Like, where is the Conservative position on mandatory vaccines or not? Why are you still vacillating on this?
Well, we're not vacillating. To be clear, the vaccine mandates mean different things to different people. And the government's announcement this week is all-encompassing. It includes even non-citizens in this country who are departing Canada to return from holiday. That never came up during the campaign. So it's a broad announcement that we are taking time to study because it has so many different aspects that were not previously discussed. Our policy is clear. We believe everyone, we encourage everyone to get their vaccination. We believe vaccines are safe and effective, and we believe that they're one of the most powerful tools for us to get out of this pandemic. That's our position.
MPs are exempt from the mandatory vaccine policy that will be instituted by the end of the month that the government's going to pass. You can't get on a plane or train. So if a conservative doesn't have two, conservative member of parliament doesn't have both vaccines, they can't travel. I'm going to ask, is your party going to flip position and say, yes, we now want all our members, every conservative MP is going to have a vaccine, and we support that to go into parliament?
Well, we support all the public health guidelines that have been put in place and that have been put in place by provincial and federal governments. And so our position is that MPs have to follow those public health guidelines. And so we encourage everyone to get their vaccination.
Right.
They're safe and effective. And so if an MP wants to board a plane, they're going to have to get their vaccination to do that.
You know that MPs get an exemption. Their parliamentary privilege allows an MP to enter without double vax, even though if you work on Parliament Hill and every other Canadian is going to be subjected to a rule that MPs are going to be exempt. Is the Conservative Party going to allow MPs to use that parliamentary privilege and have that
exemption?
Well,
that's a good question, Evan, but it's not up to the Conservative leadership. It's not up to the Conservative caucus. It's up to the House of Commons as a whole. The Speaker of the House is the guardian of the privileges and rights of members of Parliament, and that's the House as a whole that sets these rules, not the Conservative caucus.
No, the Conservative Party could just say all MPs have to be vaccinated. Every other party said that. That's the alternative, as you know.
Yeah, and we've said all Conservative MPs need to follow all the guidelines and orders that have been put in place by federal and provincial health authorities, by local health authorities.
Right.
And that's been our position. It's still our position regarding the House of Commons. Mm. Well, that's a decision for the House as a whole and for the Speaker to enforce.
Okay, Michael Chong, I really appreciate you joining us. Enjoy the weekend. Thanks for being here.
And happy Thanksgiving to you and your viewers.
You too.